It's race day in Budapest as we get ready for another round of the Formula One World Championship. We don't expect too many retirements at this track. There are plenty of current and former drivers with flawless finish rates here. In particular, Ralf Schumacher. He made it across the line in all 10 of his Hungarian Grand Prix starts. Located 12 miles northeast of the Hungarian capital Budapest, the 14 corners of the Hungaroring are steeped in history and prestige. Overtaking has always been difficult on this technical 2.7-mile circuit, but the last few years in particular have turned up some exceptional races. Let's hope we're in for another one here today. And as always, a man with plenty of racing experience joins me in the commentary box. Today, it's Anthony Davidson. Tell me, Ant, you're no stranger to surviving the melee of Turn 1. So how do you keep out of trouble when there's so much going on around you?
There are three main things to worry about there, Crofty. Positioning, awareness, and discipline. First, you have to put your car in a bit of space and make sure you have room to react to what the others are doing. Then you have to watch your mirrors and listen to the sounds around you to get a sense of where everyone is. And finally, just don't get too greedy. Just because a gap exists doesn't always mean you should go for it.
With the race minutes away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. Sergio Perez will lead us away from pole position, and it's Valtteri Bottas that completes the front row. Moving on to the rest of the grid, we have Hamilton, Verstappen, Charles Leclerc and Norris, Sainz, Ricciardo, Fernando Alonso and Pierre Gasly, Falcon, Ocon, Sebastian Vettel and Tsunoda, Raikkonen, Schwartzman, Lance Stroll and Antonio Giovinazzi, Mick Schumacher, Russell, Latifi and Nikita Mazepin. It's almost time for those five red lights to go out. Then let's see who can prevail today.
Okay, how was the pull away? You'll have a bit more grip than that on the start, but we need to warm the tyres properly now. Make sure you get some heat into the brakes as well. No rain expected. No rain expected for the time being. The rest of the grid is forming up. Be patient and watch for the lights. You're in the top 10 now. Keep it up. DRS is being enabled this lap. We can use DRS when you are within 1 second of the car ahead and in the DRS zone. We're approaching the pit window. You'll be on the mediums. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. Check your MFD for a new strategy option. Got Got that confirmed? Pit window open. Let's box this lap. Go. Exit now. We're racing on the exit. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. Green flag. We're accumulating some wear on the MG UK. To manage this, we'll need to lower our ERS deployment mode. Robert is coming in for his stop. Right, we have a very worn out MG UK. Our battery charge speed is suffering, and if it gets much worse, we could be forced to retire. The car behind is dropping back by about 0.3 a lap. This pace is strong, but be aware your tyres need to go the distance. Gap to car in front is 2.3 seconds. Okay, gap ahead is 2.1 seconds. Okay, you're catching the car ahead, but remember, we need to get to the end of the race on these tyres. We have 5 laps of fuel remaining. Our gap to the car in front is 2.1 seconds. The turbocharger is on its last legs. Let's try to keep mileage on it to a minimum. There's 3 laps of fuel remaining. The gap to the car ahead is 3.1 seconds. This is your final lap of the race. You've lost some time to the car behind. Alright, race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Yet another historic win under their belts. Well done to the team at Mercedes. What do you think it was, Ant, that gave them the edge over the competition today?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
Mercedes are on top form once again after an excellent race weekend. It's great to see them up on that podium once again. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Valtteri Bottas takes the top spot. He's our new Drivers' Championship leader after today's result. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for Driver of the Day?
Robert Schwartzman gets my vote today.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, Ant, an end to another fantastic weekend of racing. Thanks to everyone who joined us.
De fans leken er echt van te genieten. Het zag er zo gemakkelijk uit. Je team is vast in de zevende hemel met hoe je het doet. Interessant resultaat vandaag. Ben je blij met je prestatie? Wat gaf jou vandaag de voorsprong op je concurrent? Super! Dat was het.